Hello, and welcome to another release of Intel Graphics Performance Analyzers. I'm Justin Harden, an engineer on the GPA team, here to give you the highlights of our 2024.2 public release. In this release, we have redesigned the graphics monitor UI to make it easier for new users to start using the tool, run applications, and work with captured items. We've added the steps bar to suggest a workflow, along with links for quick access to the user guide. Captured items can now be found in two separate tabs, one for frames and streams, and another for traces. They can also be filtered by graphics API and file name. The full application name along with the date and time of capture are shown near the preview image. We hope these enhancements can help users identify and manage their captures. Many applications which use non-standard launchers can only be profiled when the Auto Detect Launch Application option is enabled. To simplify the process, we've made this setting available as a checkbox near the application startup mode selection. We've added more features to enhance shader code analysis and graphics frame analyzer. Additional debug information is displayed for shaders, such as compiler flags and ISA assembly headers generated by the graphics driver. That information can help understand shader execution and registry use. We've also improved our shader modification experiment. When HLSL code is modified, the ISA code will be updated accordingly. We've enhanced our pipeline state modification experiment. If a modification cannot be applied to pipeline states, the corresponding error message will be shown. Another change was made in the graphics pipeline state visualization for multiple draw call selections. Selected calls with the same pipeline state will be shown as one record. New accessibility settings have been added to the graphics frame analyzer's frame view. These settings determine the colors used in the bar chart. Three color schemes are available, along with an option to enable patterns. We hope these changes will make the tool more accessible to users with visual impairments. Let's talk about GPA framework. Our stream playback performance has been improved by up to 50% for single-threaded and multi-threaded playback. Depending on the workload, either single-threaded or multi-threaded playback can achieve better GPU utilization overall. Your mileage may vary depending on your workload and system configuration. In this release, GPA framework is built on top of Windows SDK 10.0.26.100. With this update, the framework supports the interfaces defined in the latest Agility SDK. We have also added preliminary support for Vulkan applications that use the dynamic rendering extension. And finally, we implemented many bug fixes and improvements, significantly increasing framework stability. And those are the top highlights of the 2024.2 release of Intel GPA. Try out these features and more with our free downloads of Intel GPA and Intel GPA Framework. For the full list of updates and changes, take a look at our release notes. Thank you for watching. For more information about the Intel GPA 2024.2 release and to download it for free, look for the links in the description. Remember to like this video and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel for more Intel GPA news and updates.